Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Gettin' Junked On, and today we're going to take apart this front wheel drive axle to see what's inside. This drive axle came out of my 2002 Hyundai Accent, and it's extremely similar to most front wheel drive setups. Now when we break this down, we're actually going to start on the transmission side and work our way to the outside of the car where the wheel is attached. Now I'm not saving this axle for any reason, I don't need it for a core or anything like that. So I'm going to start cutting away the boots and we're going to see what's going on the inside. All right, so here's your axle. This end here is the end that gets pushed into the transmission and it's splined, so it actually has a positive connection here. When the transmission sends power to the axle, it'll spin it like so, either reverse or forward. So we're going to start over here and there is some stretch here. I don't know if you can see it on this boot here, but this is not a solid piece that goes all the way through. So I'm not saving this for any reason, so I don't have to be gentle with it or try to keep it pretty. We are trying to destroy this to see what's going on the inside. Now the purpose of this boot is to trap all the grease on the inside and keep contaminants from getting in there and ruining this joint. So you can see all the grease and everything that's there. Now this is just a metal piece, a solid metal sleeve that this slides into. And when I remove the boot completely, I'll be able to pull them apart. Okay, so that's one half. Again, this is the half that goes on the transmission. You see inside there, nothing but grease. And it's actually kind of like a three-leaf clover design. There's a little divot there, one here, another one up on this side. And that fits this end perfectly. So I don't know if you can see that, but there's the three ends here. So let's clean this up and get a better look at it. Now I'm considering buying a parts washer. Should have had one a long time ago. Anyway, what we're looking at here are three separate bearings and they spin independent of each other, of course. And this part here looks like it could be removed. There's some kind of ring there holding it in place and there's splines here. So it looks like, not that this is serviceable, but it makes sense that they have individual bearings here and that they rotate independent of each other. And that assembly would have to be attached to this shaft anyway. So I could go through the trouble of removing that just to show you the splines, but I'm pretty sure you can see them on camera anyway. So the boot just holds all that grease in there, nasty looking stuff. And yeah, I'm gonna leave that half on there. And we're gonna work our way over here to the side that attaches to the wheel. Now this is the reason why I already had to pull this out of the car and replace it. The boot ripped and the grease started dripping out and it was just bad news. I was getting clicking and things like that while I was driving and making turns. So I replaced the whole axle. I'll put a link to that video down below in the description. Now let's cut away this boot, namely this end, so we can see the bearings and yeah, let's see that assembly. Okay, so got that boot off. That was not fun. And now we can actually get a look at what's going here on here in the inside. And again, this is the side where the wheel attaches. And how that works is you got a axle nut. You got the knuckle and everything attaches to this with the rotor and what have you. And the splines will keep it in positive contact with the drive wheel. And then the axle nut gets spun on here and holds everything together. So that's how that works. Now, on the inside here, we got to realize that this will be spinning, whether it's forward or reverse. And as the car goes up and down over bounces, this end here will be in the transmission and will be kind of at a constant angle. Now, it's the wheel that will be changing as it goes up and down with potholes and things like that. And you're going to want to have this connected to the drive wheel the whole time. Otherwise, car is not going to drive. So this joint here is able to spin 360 and is able to maintain that. Now in here, this actually looks like it's in okay shape. Despite that boot getting ripped, this is actually not so bad looking, as far as I can tell. Anyway, so you got, it looks like six of these. There's a ball there, and it sits in a groove here that's attached to this shaft. And that is pretty much as far as I know. Now, I'm not a bearing expert, but I would call this a form of a ball bearing. But like I said, what do I know? So this spins around like that. And let's see. It looks like if I were to keep going, I could pound this guy off and remove this whole unit. What I did so far was I got out my Harbor Freight portable bandsaw and I started slicing off this end here. My plan is to go through this, cut off the end of the axle here and whatever this part is, and eventually get into the bearings and everything that I was trying to show you. So that's what we're going to do now. I already did start it just to make sure that I could do this, and it seems to be working pretty good. Well, that couldn't really have gone much better, to be honest with you. I guess I could have taken more off, but it turned out to be pretty good. I missed the whole bearing assembly. I'm just a little bit closer to the end than I could have been. So I'm gonna take a little bit more off and see what I can get. But this is the other end of that bearing I was trying to point out. So after a lot of cutting with that bandsaw, I was able to remove this covering that I originally cut this end off of. So this is, again, what goes to the wheel with the axle nut there. Cut this off, two pieces, gone. And what you got left is the business end. And basically, this is what allows the wheel to go in just about any direction. Now, what I did notice is that there's six of them, these marbles, the bearings, they kind of click into place. I don't know if you could hear that. But they click into place if you do it just right. And that is my guess, that's what I'm hearing when one of these axles starts to go bad. Because when you make turns and things like that, one of the biggest signs that they're going bad is a clicking sound. So I'm guessing that it's these bearings popping in and out of place on the turns. And that's pretty much what's going on here. Now we could keep cutting and remove this outer collar that's keeping these bearings in place and get down to what looks like just a gear that's on that spline shaft. And that's the axle shaft itself. So that's pretty much all that's going on. And I'm not gonna go any further at this point. I'm really gonna stop. And yeah. So if you hear clicking in your axle shaft, make sure you replace it very, very soon, because when these guys fall out, you're gonna lose all kinds of control of the car and it gets very, very dangerous. So be very careful. Well guys, I hope you liked that video, and if you did, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Gettin Junk Done. Thanks for watching.